and welcome back to Suffrage Sundays with the Francis Willard House. I'm Kate Leobroton, and today we're going to be talking about African American women activists and their roles in both the Women's Christian Temperance Union and the suffrage movement. The WCTU was one of the few organizations in the 19th century that had both black and white members. However, the connections between race, temperance, and suffrage are complicated. Some local WCTU chapters were integrated, although most of the time there were separate chapters for black and white women. Ironically, many African American women held leadership roles in segregated local chapters that they would not have been allowed had the chapters been integrated. However, funding for those chapters was often limited, and the separation was founded on exclusion and prejudice. Today's featured document from the archives is a portrait of another notable Frances, Frances Ellen Watkins Harper. Harper was a poet, abolitionist, and committed WCTU member. This specific portrait of her is much less famous than other images and was taken by a black photographer, A.S. Thomas. The identification on the image is written in Frances Willard's handwriting. Harper held significant leadership roles in the WCTU, including the title Superintendent of the Department of Work Among the Colored People. Harper promoted interracial cooperation for temperance work, while also holding white women accountable for their roles in perpetuating oppression against African Americans. Like other WCTU members, Harper supported women's suffrage. Black activists supported temperance and suffrage for the same reasons that white women did, often with the added hope of racial uplift. Unfortunately, African American women faced challenges within the suffrage movement as well as outside of it. White women, including Frances Willard, wrestled with their own biases and priorities while trying to promote their cause. Many women who considered themselves racially progressive were willing to compromise when they thought it would attract more white women to the causes of suffrage and temperance. Black women activists then fought multiple battles at once. This activism happened as part of white-dominated organizations like the WCTU, as well as organizations founded by black women, such as Ida B. Wells' Alpha Suffrage Club, and the National Association of Colored Women, led by Mary Church Terrell, whose club motto was, "Lifting as we climb." These groups were more focused on suffrage itself, while leaders like Mary McCurdy, Harriet Purvis, Mamie Dillard, and Naomi Talbert joined Harper in linking the temperance and suffrage movements. Frances Ellen Watkins Harper's official reports to the WCTU and her poetry reflect a commitment to both temperance and women's suffrage, even with the many obstacles in the path of those goals.